It's Christmas Day. Now, a thing that I've been trying to believe, trying to do all year is collect these beers. And it wasn't as easy as I thought it would be, because normally their beers are all over the place, all over the shops and everything. But lo and behold, but coming up to the final week, my last beer shop, I finally got the final eight beers. Now I'm 44. I need to have eight beers from a well-respected and well-loved brewery, the Schuf. Now, I'll probably not pick them out in order, because I don't know which the order it is, but eight beers I'm going to enjoy it over the course of the day. The Schuf Blonde. They've all got unique caps. Now, pick this up as well. So that nine Belgian beers, nine beers, all from the same brewery, all sharing the love of the Schuf. You got the Mick Schuf as well. But yeah. The well-loved by everybody, the Sherry Schuf. Schuf Blanche. Hubbelon Schuf, which is an IPA. Is Christmas. Nice. Schuf. Nice. Now, the next two was like, I didn't know there was these two available, but Bock. Schuf Bock. 6666. 466. Which I'm looking, I've never had this beer, so I'm looking forward to it. And finally, the beer that eluded me. I thought I had all the beers, then I found out they had one more. And this is the beer that I've picked up. The last beer shop. Chou Soleil. Luckily, Rainbow had that. The majority of the Chou beers I purchased from Beer House. Yes. Looking forward to drinking these over the course of Christmas Day. How you doing? So, it's cold outside, but it's beautiful. Blue skies, sunshine, on a lower temperature. But yes, so. I have nine beers, nine Belgian beers to drink over the day. For the first one, I'm gonna keep it simple, just the can versus the bottle. So I've got Le Schuf Blonde in the bottle. I'll show you the cap shortly. And it'll be the first time I've been Le Schuf in I can, but a lot of the Belgian breweries do it now, which is good. Just means lighter, but you don't. The only side effect is you don't get the beautiful caps, which are littered all over my garden. So there we go. So I'll try the bottle first. Now, I do have the Le Schuf glass, but because it's my only Le Schuf glass and it is part of my collection of Belgian glasses and English glasses and international glasses, it's not getting used. But let me hands. It's one of my favourite glasses. I know it's not a Belgian glass, but it is my favourite glass because it was a gift from a friend. And it's a place that I adore visiting when I kept Ohio glass. So here we go. sort of beer in the glass. Shake it up a bit. It's golden amber, medium bubbles. Pulling the glass out. One of my favourite glasses, because it's such a good shape. Nice and firm and sturdy. Unlike the shoe glass, which is fragile and delicate. So, wow. So let's have a look at the artwork. Was an 8%, an 8% beer on a from a Belgian brewery on a Christmas morning. But yes, it's got basically a gnome flying a swan there, and a gnome on a bicycle, which was mostly me over Christmas and probably the rest of the year, and past as well. But yes. The very first shoof that everyone knew. And there's the can variation. A lot more yellow, a lot more artwork involved, which is good because it brings out. What's that there? Ah, shoof. Ah, that must be the brewery. But yes, it says beer, Belgian beer, Belgian beer, 8%. So it's got different pronunciations of beer. From Belgium. Again, not much on the beer itself, but we'll get to that in a moment. Yes, nice colour. Fresh lemon pie. Oh, it just smells good. Cheers. Thin on the palate, but it has a nice lemony aftertaste. Bunch of citrus, but it's not overly bitter, it's just nice and comfortable on the palate. So we go, the can version, no, don't it. It's cold. So it's taken me a year to collect all this. It's a year to collect 9 Belgian beers from one brewery. Because they're only released certain parts of the year. Certain bees. Then the Heist just got released. The Bock got released around October. Sherry, I think it's early summertime. Blanche, I think it's a certain time of year. And the Bock, the IPA, I think it's, oh, the Soleil is around summertime. It's not as aromatic as the bottle, but anyway, chill. Body's a little bit more thicker, more texture to it. But the flavouring is more subtle rather than boom in your back palate. This seems to transcend from start to finish. That's a nice beer. Yes, looking forward to the rest of the beers over the course of the day. But so far, great beers. So, at the Blondes, lovely. Now, I'm trying to decide on the next selection of beers to have. So, I've got 2 beers here, and I think I'll lead with them. Again, just had little breakfast and snacks and all that stuff. It's Christmas. So I've gone pick 2. Let's look. Okay, yeah, I picked 2. Because the others are all different styles, so I'm open to sit. Relax with them later today. So, one is classed as a winter beer, and the other one is classed as a sunny beer. And because it's the combination of the two now, a bit of a dust up here. Here we go. So a beer that eluded me. It's gonna explode. Is the Schouf Soleil. It says Belsch Sonnig beer, which means, again, because I'm using my telephone device, it says Belsch Sonnig beer. Now I just looked on the translation, and Sonnig beer means sunny beer, so, and it's sunny now. And the other one is, because it's Christmas, it is the nice Schouf, the Belsch winter beer. And the reason I've come inside instead of outside is because it's warm inside. And I just noticed both have the similar thing, but almost like you change the backdrop from summertime to wintertime. So let's have a look at the Sully, the one that eluded me the most. While I'm inside, I can Google what style is. Screen. So it's a pale, a Belgian pale. It weighs in at 8%. But Belgians make sessionable beers. Anyway, it's very carbonated. Lots of head retention. Medium to large bubbles. I did buy this from Rindle. And it expired April 2020. So let's settle down a bit. Might be a while. Settling down now. There we go. But so it is. So yes, 8 months past its date. But it did mention that it might be a little bit on the funky side. But it doesn't matter. It's all part of the fact that I get to finally drink all the Schouf beers. Okay. Try to get rid of that head. Oh. Very nice. You get a nice warm biscuity taste. Texture. Medium body. But it was very lively beer. So I'm going to try the nice. Yes, gently. But it's pouring darker in colour. And you can see the ruby brown, medium bubbles. It's brown head. The Soleil, what's the combination? Walnut loaf, cold coffee almost, and almost like a touch of leather. The artwork's pretty cool. It's just basically two gnomes over a fire enjoying a good beer, which is nice. And the other ones, two gnomes on an adventure having a picnic in the sunshine. Yeah, cheers. Oh yeah, Merry Christmas. Mm. You're getting raisins, almost dates. And back in the old days, before all this beer thing that I do now, it was basically as a child, I used to enjoy dates. I didn't know why I enjoyed dates. It's the same for with fig biscuits as well. Yes, it's kind of sweet on the back palate. Thin body, with a little bit of aftertaste, like almost like root beer, real nice. Got five more to go. Four down.